Tyler Hero chose to become a celebrity. Mm-hmm. He chose to become something outside the game.
We saw it coming, though, and we asked him about
it. Breakfast cereal,
right,
and his Tyler Tuesdays, and his Chipotle bowl, and that's all well and good. But you know what? Other players, when they see a player doing that before they've truly reached it, I don't know if I want to say there's a jealousy. They sort of take an askance view of the guy and say, wait a minute, buddy, you haven't done anything yet.
But ultimately, the team starts to get a certain level of concern.
Right.
In this particular case, the team has been concerned now for months.
What's up, guys? It's Daniel Valley, and the topic of today's video is Tyler Hero and how he's come down after a really successful rookie season. And the clip I just showed there was two Miami Heat reporters talking about Tyler Hero about like a month or so ago. But yeah, let's get into this video. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit that like button. We're on the road to 300 subscribers. In the last week or so, we've gained about like 7 or 8 subscribers really fast. So I appreciate that you guys are liking the content and clicking the subscribe button. We just need 20 more subscribers, and if we can get this done, it'll be really good. But yeah, also hit that like button like I said, and click the notification bell so you never miss out on a video. Now let's talk about Tyler Hero. Alright, let's talk about Tyler Hero's rookie season. He had a pretty successful rookie season, shooting about 39% from three, which is really good, and 87% from the free throw line. So he had some really good shooting splits, and also he just showed the type of confidence you really wouldn't see from a guy who just entered the league. But as soon as he entered the league, you knew the hype was there with Tyler Hero. And so him and the Miami Heat, they made it to the finals. But here's where things go down. Like, he had a very good series against the Celtics, so the hype just got better and better. And then in the finals, he did average a good amount of points, but he had higher usage, but his field goal percentage and his three-point percentage were slightly decreasing. So you were slightly worried, but anyways, there are a lot of high expectations for Tyler Hero going into his second year, and ESPN had him ranked really high. He had his own cereal box. He had his own like Chipotle bowl. So like, he was getting a bunch of ads. He was turning into like a celebrity that would be known out of basketball, not just from basketball, but outside of basketball. So Tyler Hero was known more now in the pop culture world than just the NBA world. So the expectations are set high, but like the two Miami Heat reporters said, he's been acting as if he's an all-star or a really good player, but he just hasn't been showing up. I mean, if you just look at the basic stats, you'd think he had a better season than his rookie season. His box score numbers have gone up, his points went up, his rebounds went up, his assists went up. Certainly that means a formula for success, right? No, that's where you have to look at the advanced analytics, because he's been shooting worse from three, worse from free throw. Like, his three-point percentage went from 39 to 36. His free throw percentage went from high 80s, now low 80s. So his shooting, first off, isn't that great. But anyways, the Miami Heat came in going to the finals last year. Now they're in the playoffs again. And so there's some speculation. Can they make another run, or are they, were they just good in the bubble? So they face off against the Milwaukee Bucks in their first series, and they get swept. So Miami basketball right now is at an extremely low point. And Tyler Hero, in this series, did extremely bad. He averaged 9 points, when in the regular season he averaged somewhere from 13 to 15 in the last two seasons. 3 rebounds, 2 assists, but that's not where it matters. Field goal percentage of 32% and 3-point percentage of 32% while having a plus minus of negative 36. So it's clear Tyler Hero could not back up his quote unquote celebrity status. He hasn't been playing the best. And he's overrated in my opinion because of how everything has been happening. Like, he has all this stuff, he's getting all these brand deals, and he's been playing good. He had a really good series, and then he broke a couple of like the Heat records, and then he was all over social media last playoffs. So the hype definitely got up, and that's where it went downward, like I had said before. So this season he didn't do as good when it came to the shooting, and his points went up, but in the playoffs everything went down. Shooting went down, points went down, rebounds, assists, everything went down. And there's some speculation that the Miami Heat were gonna actually start him when Victor Oladipo came back over Kendrick Nunn. And I think no matter how much confidence, swag, and celebrity status Tyler Hero has, he should not be a starting player for this Miami Heat team. They should have traded him when they had the chance for a superstar like James Harden, a Bradley Beal, or any other superstar like Joel Embiid that was available. Now the 76ers are doing good, and Bradley Beal and Russell Westbrook are kind of stuck in Washington, and now they're playing Philadelphia, and they're getting blown out the water. So if they got any of those two, three guys, like, they could be so much better here with the core of Jimmy Butler, Bam, and one of those other three or two or three stars. Like, Jimmy Butler hasn't been doing great this playoffs. Neither has Bam, and Goran Dragic hasn't been playing as good as last year. So just this whole Heat team hasn't been as good as their last year finals run. But Tyler Hero, if they traded him, they should definitely be way better, and they would have much more promising future and had a chance to go back to even another finals. And that's shown here by how Tyler Hero is performing. And Tyler Hero is not a starting caliber player on this Miami Heat team. And I think his ceiling is a sixth man or a decent starter. Like, I'm not thinking he's going to turn into like a superstar type player in this league, even after a really good rookie season. But he still has time to develop. I mean, he's only finished two seasons in the NBA. He just has to tone down a bit on the celebrity status and doing all those advertisements. Not saying that's bad and stuff, but he just needs to focus more on basketball. Once he focuses more on basketball, I think Tyler Hero can still be a really, really good player. It just right now, there's other people on the Heat who are doing much better, like Duncan Robinson, Kendrick Nunn, and Victor Oladipo, once he comes back, can also provide defense, and he's also clutch. So I think the Heat need to find a way to get things going with Tyler Hero this offseason, whether that's work out a trade, or that's get him like improving, or that's set a good, like, have a meeting with him, get like some good guidelines in there, how he can improve basketball and maybe stop focusing so much off the court on his personal life. But yeah, that's it for this video, guys. Tell me in the comments down below whether you think Tyler Hero is overrated. I personally think so, that he's overrated. But again, make sure you guys subscribe and hit that like button. And the main thing with Tyler Hero is he just needs to focus on basketball and basketball only. Like a player like Bam Adebayo, who won Defensive Player of the Year, doesn't have too much of a social media or personal life. He's just focusing mostly on basketball, and he almost won Defensive Player of the Year. He's an all-star, so he should maybe learn some things from his own teammate there in Miami. And we'll see if Tyler Hero can have a successful third year in the NBA. But yeah, that's it for this video. Like I said, make sure you guys subscribe, hit that like button, and click the notification bell. It's been Dinger Jelly. Have a great day, guys. And comment down below for any video suggestions. Bye.